Hello, Jess Too Good here. Today we're taking a look at the LEGO Hidden Side Paranormal Intercept Bus 3000, which has 689 pieces, 5 minifigures, and retails for $60 in the United States. First minifigure I'll take a look at is Worker Bill, nice beard piece included, and he has a new torso and leg design. The elusive LEGO shovel is included as well, and some printing on the back of his torso. And if you're curious how he looks underneath, well, that face print is relatively new, and also the torso underneath has a crocodile or alligator on it. That's kind of interesting. I wonder if that's a reference to anything. And for Worker Bill, there's the beard piece in spring green, which comes in quite a few sets. And he has these cool drill accessories, which are pretty interesting. Also, you can see his back, a little printing on his headpiece. And if you're curious, his face printing is one of the more basic haunted expressions that appear in a lot of the sets. This minifigure is Worker Nana, and the legs are the same as Worker Bill. The design for her torso is new. Do you catch the reference there? Blacktron, that's awesome, love that. The face print is relatively new as well. At the back, you can see a better look at her torso print, and she does have an alternate expression where she has a confident smirk. And for Nana, the hair piece is a new one that also came in the diner set that has two colors on it, that translucent coloring and the spring green. Also, she has a spring green pickaxe, which is really cool. And her face is the one that they use for just about all the female haunted characters in Hidden Side. And you get a look at her back hair piece as well as her back facial expression, which has a little bit of a flame to it. Here is JB, and this is the same version that's found in the train set, as well as a small lab set. Very good minifigure in my opinion. I love that hair goggles combo, which is dual molded. It's just a really interesting piece in general. Now at the back, she does have a screwdriver. I remember when I thought that was a fork, and an alternate facial expression, which I love that, where she's kind of just puffing her cheek. Also, this version has a really interesting build for this blaster here. It holds her 1x2 printed phone tile, which does appear in other sets, and it uses the Diva gun as the base. And it's just a simple build that is actually pretty cool looking. I like how it came out. Here's Jack, and this is the outfit that comes in half of the sets, being the smallest set, but also the three biggest sets. Same 1x2 phone found in all the sets. The design of his face is the one with the closed smile. Beyond that though, love this hoodie hat combo. And you have some back torso printing as well as an alternate facial expression where he looks kind of shocked. And I think that's actually the picture they use for the Hidden Side app, if I'm not mistaken. Here's Parker. This is also the version that's used in a lot of the more expensive sets. Love that torso print, which has some tacky stuff, like it's saying yo, a little lightning bolt, and what seems to be a basketball embroidery. Beyond that though, same phone that's found in most of the sets. Love that new hair hoodie combo, which looks fantastic. It's the open smile face. And at the back, very cool little printing on her torso. And her alternate face, which looks kind of shocked, if you ask me. And of course, there's the dog Spencer, who appears in most of the sets. Really adorable piece. Still love this design. Hopefully one day we could get it without the clear parts, because you could use this to just have a regular dog. So here's the build of the set. You have the construction things and then the Paranormal Intercept bus. So for the Paranormal Intercept Bus 3000, this is a great vehicle in terms of its size. Not only does it look fantastic and pretty huge for the price, but also it has a level of detail that is very creative. It reminds me a lot of the LEGO Movie 1 sets, where they would be these vehicles that transformed into different things. While it's not exactly the same vein, it does look like a modified school bus, which is exactly what they were going for. And I really appreciate how creative this looks. It really stands out as an individual LEGO set that they released that isn't part of a license, but something you just thought out. Really playing up to that modified design. I like how it's crossing out the S and H in school, and it's just the cool bus. That's awesome, and it's a very rustic look to make it look like an old retired bus. Actually, nowadays, people buy school buses, rip out all the seats, and they make them into houses, so it is very modern. At the bottom, there's a 1x4 stickered plate that says Newberry High, so it seems like this was taken straight from that school facility. There's two stud shooters, which those were actually the first stud shooters I saw in the Hidden Side line, so that's actually kind of fresh to see. Also, this little unicorn horn here, which is probably the only part of this front I don't like. It looks a little out of place, but it's not a big deal. These mirrors right here also are pretty interesting in their build, where they use the paintbrush tool. That's actually something that they sort of use as a technique in the other truck I just reviewed for Hidden Side. Now at the right side of the vehicle, there is this door that opens and leads to the inside. It's a little bit tight inside there right now. Okay, there you go. And you could get a look at JB's seat, but we'll take a better look in a second. At the side, more stickers with these nice round parts here, the quarter of the circle sides. Over here is actually a part that you could lift up or lift open, and it reveals an extra little blaster to the side and even a little bit of room there, but if you put something inside there, it's not gonna close properly. So that's really just meant as a blaster holder. And to get a better look at the front interior, we have this roof right here, which has a sticker that says 23 and also a pretty lightly printed 2x2 circular tile that looks really neat. And it could easily be removed just like that. And on the inside, you have a control stick, a seat for JB, and also a steering wheel and a double cheese slope with a sticker. What I really like too is that you could stand up minifigures in this school bus, which is perfect. Like I said, the sizing on this is incredible. And even with JB's wacky hair, ceiling fits back on there pretty easily. Moving on to the opposite side of the exterior, the bus has another one of those hidden compartments with a weapon on it. This is a slightly different design with a 1x2 printed tile, but it has the same functioning design of these two hidden compartments. Beyond that though, this side also has a ladder to climb up to the top of the vehicle, which we'll take a look at in a bit. I also really appreciate how there's four windows on each side of the vehicle. It just really portrays that school bus feel. At the back of the vehicle, there's also what seems to be like some jet powered engines here, which is pretty funny. And one of my favorite parts is a little Easter egg. Do you guys notice where that's from? That's part of the Power Miners logo. They actually reference Power Miners, which is awesome. There's also this open window as well. So at the top of this Paranormal Intercept bus, there's this cannon here, which is another super overpowered weapon, it looks like, which can be spinned around, and it has enough room at this right part here to fit a minifigure to control it with this stick. Either way, this design actually interacts with the app because it has a spinning feature, and actually you could spin it easily by pushing this wheel, and it spins from red to green or from green to red, which is pretty cool to play around with. And there's another one of those 2x2 new printed tiles. And this big radar dish looking thing, which is pretty awesome to spin around as well. And if anything looks familiar there, there's a hidden feature to interact with the app as well, where both sides reveal certain colors. So the default color, I'm glad, is just this blue and also this gray, so it doesn't look too intrusive. But if you spin it around to the right part, you could get a yellow and that newish salmon color as well. So that's really it for the top of the vehicle. Unfortunately, this ceiling part doesn't remove easily, but there's an easier way to access the back interior. And if you're wondering why that window was open earlier, well, just stick your finger right there, and this whole back interior pulls out very easily. And this is just a little research station going on here. I love some of the stickers at the back on the computer screens. One of which is a reference to Bionicle, which is awesome. So many Lego references in here. I kind of miss that about original themes. They have lots of Lego references inside. Also a printed 1x2 of the keyboard. Nice use of that part for a mouse. A seat back here so you can fit two minifigures as well as a dog. And over here is just a little microscope, which is a nice little build as well. It's not super original. I've seen it in other builds, but still is cute. And also there's this holder for a laptop. Sorry, it's hard to open up these laptops sometimes, but there's a sticker of a ghost radar. Also at the front, there's a can, which unfortunately doesn't have a printing on the side or anything like that, but it does have that 1x1 print at the top. And there's even a bed to rest a minifigure on as well, which works pretty well. It uses one of those friends' holder pieces, which also work for minifigures. And it's a nice simple build. And here's how the inside looks without the platform in, but let's just put that back inside. And there you go. And if you're curious how this looks with those side areas just open, I don't know. I don't like it too much from the front view with them open. I actually like it more with those closed. But, of course, that's an option that you can make on your own. I like that they have either way possible. Also, the bottom part of this is actually really sturdy. It does use a staggered wheel build, which means the back wheels are bigger than the front wheels to make it look more tricked out. But that is it for the build of this set. Let's take a look at actually the second build of this set, which is the construction stuff. Gee, almost forgot about this one, but this is still an awesome build. It's a porta potty, which I always love, Lego porta potties. It was something we never really got, and then we started getting a lot of them recently, which is awesome. Now, it does look a little bit awkward from the back, but from the front, it looks pretty regular. You could easily open up this door, which on the inside, there's a small toilet build, and looks like some teeth up there. Well, just move these eyes up. Take this sign with a nice 2x2 sticker on it. Put it at the bottom of the porta potty. Take these two traffic cones or construction cones here. And oh my gosh, you got a little monster of a porta potty, which looks freaking hilarious, but also really cool. And this launcher that looked awkward at the back, well, you just push it and it's a disc launcher. Now, why those are brown, that's just clay. I hope that's nothing else. But this is awesome. I love this. This set is great, all right? So let's take a look at the packaging and then the final verdict. The box for this set is one of those big $60 box sizes. At the back shows the actual set view of this and some of the different play features. As for the instructions, at the end, there's unfortunately no advertisements for the other sets. But it does have an ad for the app, which I've still got to try out. I'm probably going to do a separate little video on that, so keep an eye out for that. This will be really fun to play around with. All right, so prepared to hear Just Too Positive for like another minute, because I love this set. I have no complaints with this set. This is something I missed from Lego. A set so creative, filled with play, that can please anybody of any age, I think, and that not only pleases people like me who like play sets, but then the people who like vehicles or even the kids who like vehicles, because it's a play set vehicle and it's filled with so many hidden details and so many creative choices that this is something I've missed. These original themes I've missed so much. And I love licensed themes to death. I love D2Cs. I love all that. But just having a core play theme play set like this is just fantastic. I love all those play features. I love the general design and how creative it is. It just brings out the originality from Lego's mind. And the minifigures included are great as well. Yeah, we get three that appear in other sets, but the two paranormal versions are fantastic as well. There's some great references for Lego fans, which may be fan service, but still awesome. For $60 too, this is a fantastic value. I mean, 689 pieces. And sure, it's two builds technically, but that bus build is huge. It's filled with different features, A+ set. Highly recommend it to any Lego fan. Either way, that's it for now. If you guys are gonna buy one hidden side set, buy this one because it is a mid-range set. It's $60. It's not $130 like the school. It's not super cheap. But this one just is filled with so many fun things. Peace out. Bye.